Don't put on airs.
Jugalion. The wind.
In the year 208, after conquering the lands of Huabei, Cao Cao concentrates his efforts southward. Upon entering the Jing province, he then heads towards the core of Sun family power, Jiondong. Wavering between battle or surrender, Sun Quan makes a decision. The fate of Wu will depend upon cooperation with Liu Bei. Closing in on Jiondong, the Cao Cao fleet prepares to strike as Zhou Yu and the others craft a response.
Send a unit to stop the Wei invasion. Protect the place of prayers as well. Hold out for the southeast winds. Then the battle is ours.
This battlefield will be your last. Was an impressive battle. Until next time.
northeastern wind. Jubileon, he's a devil. Yes, one guy, begin the plan. All units, cover one guy.
Ha! The strong.
I shall put an end to this.
We must hold here. Support is coming.
Next time, you shall die. Show you! You are a fool to mock me!
Drive them all together! Stay together!
Don't fall behind.
Someone even I can't beat. Fall back.
Don't be outdone. Fight! Victories. This victory shall belong to Wu.
Fight!
Reinforcements! Press the attack!
They still have this many troops left. Don't waver! We still have the upper hand!
destroy all who get in my way. Do not think this is the end. I'll be back.
Wu's fate hangs in the balance of this fight. I shall gladly place my life on the line.
Do not say that. You should never tempt fate.
You're in good hands. You're in my hands.
After Cao Cao leads his giant navy south to Changjiang, Sun Quan and Liu Bei head to meet him at Chibi. Despite being outnumbered, the strategies of Zhou Yu and the allied forces prove successful, preserving the peace of Changjiang. Having withstood Wei's invasion, Wu prepares for a counterattack. Sun Quan, leading a large army, passes through Changjiang and towards the Wei territory. Quickly defeating the defenses at Huan Castle, the Wu army heads north. In 215, the Wu army begins the invasion of Heifei. Hearing of Wu's attack, Cao Cao sends reinforcements after consulting with Zhang Liao. The moment of truth for Sun Quan and the Wu army has arrived.
Head for the Northwest Road.
Will oppose you. Shall not die yet.
I'd be an officer.
Don't fall behind.
You've got.
Another army. still have much to learn.
Ha! I'd be an officer.
Another army?
We must fight well!
Reinforcements come.
Ah!
this. Can I face Cap Cap?
We must be triumphant.
Such skill.
Thank you. You're mine!
If Wei has Zhang Liao, Wu has Gan Ning.
I think this is the end. I'll be back.
Leading his forces north, Sun Quan takes Hefei, defeating its protector, Zhang Liao, in the process. With this victory, Wu's power spreads all the way north to Changjiang, further threatening Cao Cao's grip on the region. In the year 219, Liu Bei orders Guan Yu, who had been protecting the Jing province, to head north and attack Wei's Fan Castle. Just then, a messenger from Cao Cao arrives for Sun Quan, who had been plotting to take Jing. Meanwhile, at Fan Castle, the Wei troops find themselves surrounded by Guan Yu and prepare for a drawn-out siege. Then severe rains throw themselves at the castle walls. Can the heroes of Wu save Fan Castle from danger?
We must fight Guan Yu.
It's fine. Right now, Guan Yu is distracted by the attack on Fan Castle.
Ha!
Guan Yu, you think this water will stop me? Don't worry about the water. First, expel the enemy.
Support is coming soon. Wait a little while.
Skill, I've heard.
fool, Guan Yu. Even if we lose the castle, we must beat him.
The Shu army has encamped on the banks of Changjiang.
It's time. Spread the word. At midnight, we move to the river to face the Shu army.
Yes.
This battle shall surely decide the fate of Shu and Wu.
Wu's reinforcements headed for Fan Castle, defeat Guan Yu and manage to reclaim Fan Castle. Thanks to this victory, Wu is able to retake the Jing province. Previously, Wu had joined forces with Shu in order to oppose Wei, but relations sour as Wu plots to take back the Jing province. Infuriated, Liu Bei refuses to return the province and readies his troops for war. The Shu army takes its position at Yiling, the length of their forces reaching over 700 miles in length. The Wu strategist, Lu Xun, earnestly waits for an opportunity, and in the year 222, gives the order to go to war.
We will end this feud with Shu now. The entire army will follow Lu Jun's lead.
Lu Jun, this is your time! Show me the future by controlling this battle!
Okay, I will use all that I know. Leon must be there. However, there can be no mercy. Send a message to Zuron's unit. We will burn the Shu army as planned.
Fall behind!
the power of the Blue Dragon!
Spear of Little Dragon.
awesome.
An officer. Not again! We are back where we started!
Ah!
too deep. Be careful.
Leon is good. That was a strange trap.
Don't let anyone pass you.
Strength alone. was unable to repay Liu Bei's trust.
Don't fall behind!
Restoration of the Empire.
Yeah!
sorry to say, but I must break our oath.
Don't you dare disturb my meal! Or would you prefer me to eat you?
I'm sorry, but there's a large army approaching from the east!
What? To the east? Those sissies from Wu?
That sounds very interesting. Perhaps we should oblige them. Get ready for battle! Quickly!
Yes!
Determined to take the Jing province, the Shu army moves to attack Yi Ling. Lu Xun, the accomplished Wu general, notices a weakness in Shu's extended formation and exploits it, resulting in victory for the Wu forces. With Shu eliminated, the Wu lands spread even further west. In the year 225, after stabilizing the Central Plains region, Wu sets its sights on the lands of Nan Man. With most of their forces located in a position to easily move south, Wu enjoys a distinct advantage over Wei, whose forces are concentrated in the north. News of Wu's southern invasion reaches King Meng Huo of Nan Man. In order to meet this attack, the Nan Man people hurriedly prepare for the attack and strengthen their defenses. Waiting for Lu Xun and the rest of the Wu forces was an army whose likes had never been seen before.
This battle is not an act of aggression. We will attack their spirits and make them submit.
King Meng Huo! Your tactics! Next time, I'll defeat you!
Okay.
officer.
Don't fall behind!
You're here. You're early.
haven't beaten me yet!
Don't fall behind!
Thank you. looks like their spirits are not yet broken.
Single battle yet!
Great King! Flee!
Oh, sorry.
It is not that easy to pass. We must fight well!
Can't I win?
Don't fall behind.
Splendid.
What? You've offended my husband too many times. You will pay with your life.
this will be the last push.
King, are you okay?
Can't hold them.
Yeah.
fall behind! Reinforcements come.
Cannot handle a seventh time. I shall concede.
Determined to quell the rising threat from the south, Lu Xun sets out and battles with the strange Nanman troops. Following a hard battle, Wu's victory earns the respect of the Nanman army. Having built up their power, Shu once again sets out to do battle with Wei. The Wu viceroy, Zhou Fang, comes up with a hidden poison plot and pretends to defect to Wei. In an effort to prove his allegiance to Wei, Zhou Fang even cuts his own beloved locks of hair, thereby tricking Cao Zhu. In the year 228, serving as a guide, Zhou Fang leads Cao Zhu and the Wei army to Youting. There, Lu Xun and the other Wu generals lie in ambush, waiting for the right moment to strike.
The preparations are now complete!
Lu Xun, what do you think of this plan?
The enemy is Sima Yi. It will only be a matter of time before they see through this. The timing must be perfect. We must all do our part. Take the forts on the east and west and lay siege to Cao Zhu.
Won't you cross swords with me?
sir.
I will remember your face.
Yeah!
nothing my claws cannot tear. There is no glory to be won from this battle.
On your death. This war is not over. We shall meet again.
I'd be an officer.
Stalwart hero!
skill.
This is the end. I'll be back.
Council, is our strategy agreed upon?
Enough. Cheap tricks won't work at this point. We must believe in Wu's power. Win or lose, this is the end!
Yeah.
Thanks to the plot of Zhou Fang, Wu successfully led the Wei forces into their territory, where Wu was waiting, and defeats Cao Zhu and the Wei army. Thanks to this victory, morale within the Wu ranks reaches an all-time high. Having gained strength, Wu is determined to advance north in order to challenge Wei for supremacy. Sun Quan leads his forces towards the new castle of Heifei. There to meet him is the veteran commander Sima Yi. In 234, the young Wu general Lu Xun makes an attempt on the castle at Heifei. Which shall prevail, the defensive Wei or the offensive Wu? The battle to determine the fate of both countries is about to begin.
The fate of Wu hangs on this battle. All units, attack the enemy's main force.
You can pass. Try it.
Thank you.
better than I thought. But you're still in my hands. Go forth!
They're attacking from both sides. Now, concentrate all efforts on the enemy in front of us.
This doesn't look good.
We still have manpower. This is the last of their forces. Kill them all! fall behind.
better general than I have heard.
Stop!
die. Not yet.
are a stalwart hero.
Will oppose you.
You are a stalwart hero.
to kill one of such skill.
疲劳，装作无所谓，不露出丝毫。